What's up, everybody? This is Shanti Das, and I just want to let you know that life is a journey, not a destination.
Very few women are in positions of power in hip-hop, but Shanti Das broke the industry's glass ceiling. Now she's written a book about her career with advice for other women. Frederica Whitfield sat down with her for our What Matters segment.
Shanti Das,
yes.
Good to see you.
Good to see you, too. Thanks
and
for having me.
And the book, The Hip-Hop Professional, this really is for women in particular to help them understand the dynamics of a male-dominated industry. Why did you feel like it was important to have this kind of guidepost?
Well, I feel like, one, as an African-American woman, having worked in entertainment for almost 20 years, I really didn't feel like there was a book out there like this. I think as a woman in any business, it's important to make sure you go in and demand your respect. And there are just certain ways that you should carry yourself as a woman. You have to really be on your toes.
It can be so intimidating, especially a young person, your college student age. I'm kind of afraid to raise my hand or be assertive because I'm really still trying to figure out the job. So how did you do that successfully?
I wasn't shy. I was going to a lot of music industry conventions back then when I was networking, trying to get into the business. I walked up to Russell Simmons at the Jack the Rapper convention and I said, "Hey, Russell, you don't know me, but by the end of the convention, you will." And he thought, "Who is this little girl standing in front of me?" But I did just that. You know, I was really aggressive and assertive and I wasn't afraid.
Just need to take the time and start getting involved in as many activities as possible. Find out really what your passions are, where your likes are. And that's just what I did. I started giving campus tours because I knew I liked to talk and I liked, you know, to meet new people. So my sophomore year, I gave tours to the incoming freshmen. And then I started getting involved in the radio station. I was like, well, if I shadow this guy in Atlanta, maybe there's a station here that I can work at. So we had a little college radio station called Gig 9. Started volunteering there and then actually started working more at the station in the promotions department. And then they voted me assistant promotions director. So I was involved in a lot of campus activities with the radio station. And then I thought, well, it might be cool to see if I could do the on-air thing. So I, you know, put a little tape together and auditioned to be on air. And I made it. But I was going from like 2 to 4 in the morning. It was a graveyard shift. But I knew it was an opportunity for me. So I kind of took it and ran with it.
She was the first person to believe in Southern hip hop. Like that's how important this is. The Outkast wouldn't be the Outkast that they are if it wasn't for Shanti. Good hip hop also.